Hey, hey there. Do you like brutal action video games? Do you like hack and slash combat and fast-paced gameplay? Do you like indie games that have a knack for great art direction and surreal artistic flair? And anime quality originality with visual storytelling?
Wait, no. Come back. I promise you won't be disappointed.
If you said yes, well then this game's for you.
Fury is an enjoyable little cutlet of an indie game from 2016 that I regard as one of the best indie games of the past decade. It won me over with its rhythmically resonant soundtrack, its eye-catching colors, cel-shaded art style, enemy designs that are just so inspired, and of course, the brutal reaction-based combat. Developed by a French studio, The Game Bakers, Fury just stands out for one reason: repetitive gameplay done right. Now, repetitiveness or repetition in video games is usually frowned upon. And unless you're playing Nier Automata, you're probably playing a game that's repetitive in some way, shape, or form. Be it in terms of gameplay mechanics, world design, or combat, almost every game you've played relies on one set of core mechanics. These mechanics allow you, the player, to go from start to finish without having to think outside the confines of said mechanics. But there is a but. It's not always bad for games to be repetitive. Repetitiveness is at the core of every game. It's just how game developers keep the events around the gameplay fresh that matters most. Take, for example, the many weapons of Bloodborne, which encourage replayability, a strategic approach, and build variety, making every playthrough seem different. Or perhaps God of War or Devil May Cry, where the games have self-contained yet repetitive combat mechanics, but every challenge is met with a worthy reward that tends to change up the gameplay ever so slightly. Fury gets this absolutely spot on. With just a few buttons to remember and four key moves to master, at the center of this game is an incredibly repetitive gameplay loop. One that relies on skill and endurance as a test of strength while rewarding the player with progression and new events as a hook. These events are the brutally challenging and sometimes soul-crushing, unconquerable boss fights that make up this boss rush game. It doesn't necessarily reinvent the wheel in terms of its genre, but what it does extremely well. But more on that later. In Fury, you play as the Stranger, just your average 60fps guy whose hair lives in a 24fps world. Equipped with only a katana, a repeating pistol, and that jumpsuit from Ready Player One, our silent protagonist must escape from the cosmic prison he is in by defeating the guardians that keep him chained for eons. These guardians are the bosses who essentially make up the chapters of the Stranger's story. Beating each guardian boss rewards you with pieces of an overarching narrative, drip-fed to you by the voice, the individual with a furry fetish who freed you in the first place. The game bakers don't kid around when they say they make their games like they're cooking food. They do it with love. And in this case, they've got a recipe that I'd award a Michelin star. The ingredients to make Fury are influence and inspiration from many other games and even some anime, which is more than evident. Melee combat is reaction-based and fast-paced like Devil May Cry or Bayonetta. Boss encounters are isolated and self-contained with multiple phases like Metal Gear Solid. Bullet hell mayhem like Exit the Gungeon keeps you on your toes, and a control scheme the likes of which you'd only find in old arcade games like God Hand give you the incentive to get better and master combat. Add to this a quenelle of stunning artwork and character design by Takashi Okazaki, creator of Afro Samurai, and a sprinkling of electronic synthwave soundtracks by some incredibly talented indie artists, and you've got Fury. I would break combat into three parts. Melee combat has you use your quick reaction times and the katana to slash, parry, or charge up attacks against the guardians. Ranged combat involves a whole lot more dodging or shooting back. Adaptation is what I call the mix of two playstyles, since most bosses will bamboozle you with a combination of well-telegraphed and well-timed attacks that'll keep you on your feet at all times. By that simple teardown, combat may seem one-note and repetitive to many who haven't played the game. But those who have will agree when I say Fury does repetition right. Every boss you face exudes a different personality and brings to the fore new styles of gameplay. They've got gimmicks that contribute to their individuality while also carrying the baggage of their past. While not very deep, it does the job of giving them a reason to exist in this world. And honestly, that's just good enough for me. Oh, and the bosses are very versatile as well. BDSM girl likes to be spanked a bit before she unstraps herself and bends you over sideways. Cyber Grandpa bends time and primarily uses ranged moves unless you take off his headphones, after which he beats you like your parents did. Sniper Wolf plays hide and seek before blasting you with a one-shot kill. And Katana Sensei busts out a wooden oar because for some reasons that's meant to be better than a sword? The list goes on and on. But among the ever-changing nature of combat that is easy to learn and hard to master, the ability to adapt, struggle, and conquer is expected from the player. The reward for this is a long walk to the next event in the story, guided by the almost poetic verses narrated by the voice, whose motives to free you are made clear at the very end. Barring a few frame drops, sound glitches, clipping issues, and animation glitches during the walking segments, the game has a certain ebb and flow to it that kept me hooked. Yes, the writing can be campy and comic booky, with the same nature of voice acting to go with it. And honestly, anything else would have contributed to the detriment of this game. It's the motivational one-liners that the voice doles out during every victory walk. It's the bosses with their constant taunting and egging that makes you furious. It's the stunning cel-shaded visuals that keep you mesmerized throughout. It's the fantastic cyberpunk sound design that was clearly way ahead of its time. It's the satisfying combat loop with the seamless phase transitions that make you want to get better. It's the surreal, upbeat, and sexy soundtrack that makes you play to the rhythm, and the optional endings that make you come back for more. This game deserves all the praise it gets and then some. Fury has been out for close to 5 years now. The PlayStation, Xbox, PC, and Nintendo Switch all have support for it. And if you haven't played it, you totally should. So that was my very straightforward review for Fury, a game that I played once again recently and had to talk about. More poet reviews are coming soon, obviously. It's just that this one felt like it needed to be more traditional. As always, if you like this one, leave a like, subscribe if you haven't already, and be sure to comment. Take care of yourselves. Be safe out there, be kind to each other, and I'll be right with you once more. See you soon.